When the Couse-Sharp Historic Property applied to the National Trust Program, they had everything we were looking for in a property: an artist of significance, a wonderful preserved set of studios and a home, models, stands, costumes that were used for the posing of models and the making of pictures, and they had strong staffing and board support to maintain the property and keep it going.
The Tao Society of Artists is crucial to the Eurocentric artistic traditions of New Mexico, and of course the story that we all like to tell is the broken wagon wheel. 1898, Blumenschein and Bert Phillips, who were on their way to Mexico to look for painter's mecca. They ended up in Taos and really found that that's where they needed to be, that it had everything that they were looking for.
In the late 19th century, if an American artist really wanted to study and become renowned, they would travel to Paris and study there. And a number of the Taos founders did travel to Paris and then came back to the United States looking for a place to work where they felt they could paint something that was American, authentically American. We're beginning to recognize, as is the National Trust for Historic Preservation, the value of artists' homes, that these are very important historic sites in their own right.
We founded in 2001 a New Mexico nonprofit corporation named the Couse Foundation. Its mission is twofold. One is to acquire and preserve this marvelous collection of historic buildings and their contents. The other, once the purchase is completed, is to foster, promote, provide education, training, and research involving Southwest art, in particular these artists and this site, but also on a wider scale, the Taos Society of Artists and its fit in the assembly of wonderful American art colonies.
I look for studios and homes, if the two are attached to one another, that have the richest set of ingredients to helping us learn our cultural past. And the Couse-Sharp Historic Site is one of those. It really feels as if those artists are still there.
In 1902, my grandfather ran into Ernest Blumenschein on the streets of New York. They were friends. Blumenschein, who had come to Taos 4 years earlier for the first time, said, "Well, you better go to Taos. It's perfect for you up there." So 2 weeks later, my grandparents were and my father were on the train and arrived at Tres Piedras Station, took the stage from there that was run by Long John Dunn, cross down the canyon gorge and into Taos, and that was their introduction to Taos in 1902. And even though it was the hottest summer ever recorded in Taos, and my grandmother was miserable because of the heat, my grandfather, of course, was so happy with his painting that it didn't bother him at all.
Sharp met Couse in Taos, and there's a letter that talks about the day that he met Couse. He said, "Couse is setting up a studio, likely to be here for many years," was what Sharp said.
They brought new decorative ideas of how to look at the West, whether it was light, whether it was fractured space, whether it was some kind of tapestry effect. These were immensely talented artists who got better and better.
Like the Barbizon painters in France, some of the painters in England, they were searching for a place that they could settle but sort of identify with and establish a true American school of painting.
One of the important participants in the success of the Taos Society of Artists was the Atchison, Topeka, and Santa Fe Railway. For 23 years, a Couse image was used on the calendar, and it was considered a series of Indian life. That was the thing that they were trying to promote.
This is what visitors come to see, and they expect to see in our museum, and they're very disappointed if they don't see the Taos artists. Their art is very well known worldwide.
My grandparents in 1909 bought this wonderful piece of property on Kit Carson Road. It has a very long history going back to the 1830s. The first thing that they did was to add on a big studio wing that my grandfather designed. And my grandmother put her artistry into making a wonderful garden. So she began that right away, and over the years developed that into what became a very famous garden, which we're starting to restore.
The Couse Foundation is extraordinarily grateful for the stewardship of the Couse descendants, the grandchildren of Andrew Irving Couse. What we have done is started a fundraising campaign because we have an option to purchase from the owner this entire site with all the buildings and all their contents for only $990,000. We're then in a position to obtain funding to provide programs there, help preserve the structures, make them more accessible to an ever-increasing audience of visitors and scholars.
I have found that people are interested in how artists work. This is as close as you come to allowing people to see that these artists were real people, that they had real lives, and that the process of their work was a serious enterprise as professional artists.
If you go to the artist's site, the place of creation, and you walk through those spaces and see relationships between, for instance, the studio and the home, or the studio and other artist studios, or the artist's space versus the community, you begin to get a sense of the making of a work of art in a more social and human space. And I think this teaches us something in art history that we can't get any other way.
The family found thousands of negatives of photographs that he had taken in order to prepare for his paintings, and many, many letters and correspondence. All of those are enormously valuable. It's my understanding that the family will donate the negatives for the photographs and the correspondence to the foundation so that it will all be preserved and available to the public.
One thing is for sure is that it should be preserved as the Couse-Sharp site. And this is of great importance to creating New Mexico as the state of the arts.
The fact that Sharp had two studios there, Couse had his studio and home there, it's unique in the richness of the history.
History never reveals the alternative. But if the Couse studio and Sharp studio and foundation is not preserved, what is the alternative? What's going to happen to all of that? What happened to all that wonderful history and the romance of the West, probably the most important and popular art society in the West? You know, it ranks with the Hudson River School and the Brandywine and the American Impressionists. The only thing we have out West is the Taos Society of Artists. We need to save these things, because it bothers me if we don't. I mean, it's the alternative that you can't live with.
For further information, please check the KouseFoundation.org website. There's only one way to get this project done. It's for you, private individuals, and your companies, and your funds, or your foundations, and your friends, to please step forward and let this happen. Without it, it could be lost forever.